So then I told him, if he walks out, it's over.
Wait, wait, so you broke it off?
Well, not exactly.
This is the same shit I'm always talking about. You always have the same issue.
Okay, you're not my daddy. It's not your job to fix me, Lonnie.
That's what you do. You help the other person when they're in need, but you never want to recognize that.
Well, let me help you out. You definitely are headed the wrong way.
And where am I supposed to be going?
You could get out, but that's not the point. I'm over it and it's done.
Yet you still sleep in his t-shirts every night.
Okay, well, I don't see what's wrong with that. They're comfortable and I just sleep in them. It's not that serious. Look, I don't do redos. You're missing the whole point.
I mean, like, once I break up with somebody, it is completely over. You hear me?
Wow, well, I feel personally attacked.
You know what, Kelly, I'm gonna let you go.
But you know what, girl? I am proud of you. I'm so proud of you. Because I wouldn't be able to do it. You know, I would be lonely. I just realized that I am that girl that gets back with all her exes.
So yeah, you know what? I'm gonna just talk to you tomorrow, Callie.
Okay, no. Listen, I didn't really mean it like the hello.
One day I will learn from my mistakes.
Bye. Okay, I'm coming.
Hey.
Malcolm?
Yeah.
What are you doing here?
You said to come over. Said I might be in the shooting. Did the police come in?
Was confused. It was probably a possum. Definitely a possum.
Yeah.
But everything's fine, so thanks for coming to check. Wait. How'd you get here?
Well, Mom Deuce got sick, decided to sell 6 units, come back sooner.
So you've been here for 2 months?
Well, maybe like a month and a half. I mean, I wanted to reach out, but
no, it's fine. Actually, you can actually go. I'm fine. I'm good. You can go.
At least let me check the rest of the house. Unless you already have a checker.
This is a sleeping shirt.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure.
I guess you were really lonely out there in Seattle. No family, no friends, nothing. Just sad. Rain.
You know, you should have came with me.
You know, this little trip down memory lane has been really cool, but maybe we should do this at another time. You can go.
Big ass possums.
Wait! Look, it's been 3 years. I'm not your responsibility anymore.
So why you text me now?
Those are my little brothers.
Oh, really? Your 7-year-old brother real saucy now?
Okay, well, what did you expect? You thought I was just gonna wait for you forever? And it don't even matter because that situation is done, just like we are done. I don't even know why you're still here. What is it?
Possums.
What?
Possums. Big ass possums.
Well, see, I told you. Now you can go. I appreciate you coming over and checking to make sure I'm okay. But as you can see, I am okay. Oh my God, there's somebody in the house.
Where?
I have no clue, but that is not my bag. What the fuck are you laughing at?
It's my bag. I figured you called me over for some late night booty call type of deal, and Honestly, I thought this might be a fresh start for us.
That's very presumptuous of you.
Tell me if I'm...
Malcolm!
Marie! Marie! It's okay. I got your text. At first, I thought you was on some booty call shit. But then you talking about somebody breaking into your house? I get here and you got a bottle of wine, so I'm like, shit, she really trying to set the mood. I look and you got this fool all on top of you pushing up on my girl, trying on my shoes? I was gonna play it cool. Soon as he turned his back though, had to rush him. I ain't wanna hurt you though. Let's go. Marie, let's go.